Bringing you coverage of the Mad Catz CSGO Invitational from Vienna. I'm Richard Lewis, and next to me is the 1.6 legend, Threat. Now, the next game, we're jumping straight into it, because to make up time, you probably noticed we had a bit of filler at the start, where we were talking for 45 minutes, and Joe Miller took the mickey out of me for trying to say that it was like the CPL, and of course it isn't there yet, but in principle it's like CPL, Joe. Stop being a stickler. I know I said some terrible things about you in the past, but you know, I was an angry drunk back then, so that's just one of those things. Anyway, so yeah, we're going to quickly jump on to this game. It's actually about to go live. It's another great game. It's VERYGAMES. It's VERYGAMES and Team Alternate, and from what I'm being told, and again, we're getting results just filtering in the same as you guys, that Team Alternate had a good first game. So this is going to be integral into the lay of the land. So just going to jump on everything that's going on and have a look around, actually, who's in. You know, I haven't got any models at the moment on my thing. Oh, that's better. Right, okay. So, oh, here we go. It wasn't live. I was just about to jump into it. So this is about to go live now. And Alternate are going to be on the CT side, and VERYGAMES are going to be on the T side. And again, it's another Dust 2 extravaganza. So everything that we said about the game tactically is going to hold true, isn't it, Bjorn? It's just going to be like the first game, because it's Dust 2 again.
Yeah, I completely agree. And though I think this game will be much more one-sided in favor of VERYGAMES, of course.
Actually, this is good. It's bought us some time. We've got a stop coming in. I'm not quite sure what that's about. So that's going to allow us to pick out our teams. And what we'll do is I'll pick out the Germans again. I'm backing the Germans quite a lot at the moment. The team Alternate, I'm going to tell you a little bit about them. Basically, I think a lot of people won't know them in 1.6. They're quite well-known source players. One of the things you will notice is there's a player called Crystal there. Don't confuse him if you're a 1.6 fan for the other Crystal. That isn't him. He is a very young German player who adopted that name back in the day, and basically it stuck with him. He's not got the best of reputations, but I'm not going to labour the point about how he used to be a cheat. He did. But what I'm going to do is instead going to talk about you know, the good points. And this is a team Alternate, that made it to the finals against all the odds of the last great CSS LAN, which was Copenhagen Games in 2012. Nobody saw that coming. They put in a huge game against Mouse Sports, which of course, War Clown, who's in our analysis booth, he actually commentated on that in Copenhagen Games, and that might have been the fabled, if it goes to overtime, I'm going to get naked match. So there's a bit of continuity going on throughout here, a nice little narrative building. But anyway, so Alternate, I say if you had to watch a player, it's kind of hard. Like, I like Solek, because he's very... he's an old school established, he's like the older player. But one of the things I will say is, I've already talked about him, Crystal is a guy who, despite his reputation, has gone on to be like a really, really, really strong player. I think they're a little bit weaker than what they probably were in terms of CSS at Copenhagen Games. But I definitely think Crystal's a player worth watching. Mm. He's very good with a rifle, pinpoint aim. He's not particularly aggressive. The one thing he has done as he's moved forward is that he's got smarter as he's learnt the game, learnt the trade, so to speak. And he plays situations quite intelligently. So he's got a lot of experience, despite still being one of the younger guys on the team. So that leaves you to tell us something about VERYGAMES.
Yeah, VERYGAMES, of course, probably the second best CSGO team mm-hmm. right now. I mean, they come second to NIP in basically in all tournaments. Mm. Their players, the Madfraggers, Kenny S, and their new player Scream, they haven't done like exceptionally well with their new lineup, but I think they have like a complete team. Like, they have two Madfraggers and three like support players, and that's like a good balance. You don't need all Madfraggers, and that's why they're so successful, I think.
I mean, a lot of people have talked about Existence and how he's pretty good in CSGO and CSS. I mean, do you feel it's a similar situation to maybe, you know, we've had a laugh about our striker with Imaginary. Is Existence that far behind his teammates, in your opinion?
I don't really know. It's quite hard. If a team is doing so well, it's really hard to blame somebody, if you know what I mean. Like, I feel like they all have to like function well together to be performing so well as they have been. So they shouldn't really make any roster change. I actually disagree with their roster change with the Scream for what play was it? NPK?
Yeah.
No, RPK.
Yeah, RPK. Yeah, RPK. Yeah, MBK's. He was basically in the same position Kenny S was around. So yeah, we've got. I think we've got people switching over. So it looks like we're about to go live. Which player should we watch from VERYGAMES beyond?
I would say Kenny S. It's a great op maps, and he is a VERYGAMES opper, of course. So I say Kenny S.
Okay. Well. There you go. I mean, he's going to be well known to most people anyway, I would say. So we'll see. I still haven't got auto-director working. I should have done that in the break. I apologize. I will try and be a good cameraman. It's hard. I find it very hard to do things at once. Anyway, you can see how VERYGAMES are set up here. They've got this glut buy going on. They've scouted mid, and they're just having a look to see who's crossing over and, before they make their move. And one thing you can say about VERYGAMES is they are methodical. They do think a lot about the game. They are very smart. They're used to success. They're used to winning. And they know what it takes to do so. So it's going to be interesting to see how they match up against the team that finished way above them at that CSS LAN at Copenhagen Games. It's VERYGAMES only managed to make it to 12th. It's not the same lineup, but it's worth mentioning anyway. So Smith is going to get first blood for VERYGAMES. He's going to get a nice little kill there. Take out the experience head of Solek. And Felix is very low as well. So they've now got options. They've now got options. It looks like they're going to elect to go short, is it? They're going to smoke it off, but not pushing. You can see Nathan's holding long, just waiting for that rotate behind if anyone gets greedy, and that's the play, spamming the door. You can see that Scream gets taken down from behind, but while Kenny S picks up another kill, so Crystal it was, and we talked about that earlier, how he likes to get into these smart positions, managing to get a kill from behind. It's still a 43 advantage, but Felix is going to drop down, and with that nade coming in from Crystal at the same time, all of a sudden it's completely swung, and you can see that alternate. Well, they did have a numerical lead for the briefest period of time before MBK gets killed. Kenny S is going to answer that and take down M&L. So it's a 6 HP clutch, I think 5 HP clutch from Felix that needs to happen if alternate to get this round. So the bomb's going down from Kenny S, and you can see that Felix, if you look on clutch cam, he's just going to jump through the smoke here. Is he in the window? He's got another smoke of his own, so he's going to throw that over.
Don't know what the point of that smoke was, really.
Well, no, it's and there you go. You can see it absolutely played no part at all. Were you? Is there anything that you saw that was quite intelligent or surprising about that pistol?
Not really. I mean, VERYGAMES did a very slow push. As you said, they're really methodical. Mm. They didn't have like a plan to begin with. They just had everybody peeking everywhere, and they just played reactively to what their opponents were doing.
And what about, as well, I mean, the kind of alternate reaction to it? Because they played their way back into it, almost. It looked like they were, at one point, they did have a numerical advantage. Did they play the situations, you know, that bad, or was it just out-aimed?
I think they had very low HP, and Kenny S frag onto that hole in B was the key frag to the round. If the CT would have managed to kill him, they would have a 2v1, and they would have a better chance of winning that round.
Okay, well, the eco round goes the way we expected, which is how we like to do things. We like to just talk over the eco rounds and find them an unnecessary distraction, and that's, you don't really see a lot of eco rounds in CSGO. I mean, you didn't really see a lot of eco rounds in 1.6, like a deco round.
No, yeah, deco special rounds. I thought you said eco rounds,
yeah,
and I was
an
like...
an eco round, yeah, yeah. Well, you don't really see it.
Yeah, but I mean, the P250 is cheaper and better, so it doesn't really make any sense.
So, having a look to see, sweeping around the map to see where the action's going to be. But again, VERYGAMES, even though they know it's another eco from alternate, they're not over being overly aggressive and committing. They're waiting for alternate to peak, and indeed, it's going to be Crystal again who gets the kill there for alternate. So he's had a pretty good start to the game.
That was a really unnecessary peak from Scream. He actually peaked into B2 and he was all alone. I actually think Crystal could have even picked up his gun if it was just
there might still be an opportunity to do that, but he hasn't gone aggressive yet. And again, like we were talking about, he played that quite smart. Rack, that was a bit naive. I think he probably should have heard the people on short. He pushed into the box and then got took down by Smith. And now VERYGAMES are in a good position to push up into this short area. They're going to get onto a bomb site, and bomb's going to go down. There's someone close, and that's just, well, Great little reaction shot there from Smith, and Existence is going to mop it up, and that is going to be 3-0 for Team Verygames. So the all-important buy round coming in now, and we'll see whether, Crystal is going to be AWPing this game, which is something he's done, you know, in the past. He can use the AWP quite well. He did make his name primarily as a rifler, but again, as he's enjoyed something of a renaissance, as he's got a little bit more experience, he has moved to being an AWPer. So, be interesting to see the duel of these guys, Kenny S and Crystal. But in the end, it's MNL, who was Alternate's MVP at Copenhagen Games, getting that first kill, and Verygames are going to not push there. They're just going to keep the bomb in the mid area. You can see as well they might be thinking about moving up short.
That was another unnecessary push there from NPK. Yeah. I mean, like, why should you push long by yourself? It doesn't even make sense. He got in like 30 damage, no, less than that, 20 damage on Rack, and then he just died.
Yeah, I mean, is this indicative of their confidence, maybe? That they're going and they're expecting to get kills, or...?
Yeah, exactly. Maybe they're too confident. Mm. I don't know.
Well, it's a very slow round again, so I'm hoping you guys are staying awake, because these rounds are going at a very slow pace, a direct contrast to what we saw in our first game between Imaginary and TCM, another French and German matchup. But you can see now that Verygames are going to commit. Their Virgo smokes down. They know what's going on there. Scream is going to wrap around onto B. Oh, and that's a great little headshot from him. Catch Crystal dropping. Solek's going to take down Existence. You can see that Rack's going to jump through the window. He should get the kill onto Scream. He does. Scream boosting up onto those boxes. And Verygames have rotated round now. And what they're doing is they're going to be literally... I thought he was going to be able to bump it in the end. No, they're not. Solek with a great flash. And he's took down Smiths and Kenny S. I thought, honestly, they were just going to get an easy plant there. No.
No, I didn't see how Scream died. I think if Scream would have survived just playing super defensive inside B, that they would have been much better off.
He died jumping up onto the window.
Okay, that another like way too aggressive move from Scream. He should have just stayed put, wait for his teammate, and like just controlled the bomb site.
Well, absolutely, and you can see that it's played into... the hands of what they're trying to do here, Ultimate. Now, it looks like we've got Auto Director going, so you'll get to see the action. So, great news, everyone. I am no longer the cameraman, so there we are, brilliant. All I have to do now is press tab. We've got some action going on short. You can see as well, Crystal, just using that AWP, looking into that smoke. In days gone by, he would be able to see that guy on the right, but he can't. He doesn't have X-ray vision at LAN these days. And again, it's just a slow round. I mean, like, do you think that Verygames need to mix this up beyond, like, because these rounds are so slow, I think it gives Alternate perhaps a little bit of time to set themselves, and there's not enough time in the round for, like, crazy rotates?
I don't know, really. I mean, it didn't work last round because NPK just went out long and died early in the round, so it's just four rounds into the game. I think they should just play their standard game.
Well, here happens. We go. It looks like he's going to come in at short, and you can see we've had another trade there. Kenny S is going to rack up that AWP kill. He's going to get a face full of nade, and it's Solek that's playing smart. MDK trying to do something at long, not really happening for him at the moment. And it's a 4v4 situation. Verygames having to work hard to get another save bombsite. Ultimate, very disciplined, playing very dug in at the moment, and tactically astute. So what we're seeing here is, absolute carnage, it looks like. There was a bit of a spray off Verygames that he managed thanks to the flash back going, jumping things. He quickly turns around to go along, even though he's close to the other guy. He's going to kill on Kenny S, going for a close spam. He's going to get his pistol out, and in the end, Smith is going to win that duel. MVK is going to be sat here at long, just having a look around, and I don't really see what Crystal's going to do here. I think he's just going to try and get a gun and go and save it. And that's definitely the right call. And this is going to give Verygames a 4-1 advantage. We'll just have a quick look at the frag chart. You can see for yourself that it's Smiths, the established former AWPer. Again, another French legend, one of the most accomplished players France has ever produced on 6 kills for 2. And at the top, it's the old boy, the veteran Solek, just at the top with 3 kills but 4 deaths. So Alternate, not really hitting their stride. Crystal did manage to save that AWP. In these situations, Bjorn, where you save one AWP but everyone else is eco, what do you typically do?
I mean, the AWP have to be like way aggressive, But still, when he dies, somebody needs to be able to pick up his gun. So, right. Like, taking easy picks in middle and going aggressive on the short is, like, the terrorist, they know it's going to happen, but it's still the best thing to do.
Yeah. Well, Crystal didn't get a kill there, but he did attempt what you were talking about. He got legged for his troubles. So Kenny S, and you can see there, I think what Crystal's doing is saying, you take this gun rack because I'm pretty low HP. So again, as you said, recycling that gun, keeping it going. Again, a lot of belief in the round, but it amazes me how slow VERYGAMES are still playing this. Incredible. So Rack's kind of hopping around with the gun. VERYGAMES, as you saw, are just kind of teasing and titillating their opponents, just peeking short, going here, but not committing, not overly committing. Rack, again, going for the peek, and you can see this push long's coming in. There's a big stack at long here for alternate, and NBK has been peek happy, so he's going to call one on the box. Does he realize that it's a stack yet, though? So he's going to get one headshot, he's going to get two headshots. And I'll say it was a door banger first one, but still, he's gonna get the third frag. He is. He knows he can afford a WASDA. He's had a look around, and I think that's pretty much going to be the end of it. Rack will probably be tempted to save this gun again. Crystal, very low HP. And it's just another round for VERYGAMES. So the slow, methodical play, it's not hugely entertaining to watch. It's not exuberant. But while I say that, there's a bit of a comeback here. The team alternate players in upper have managed to get two kills. They're going to be chased down, though, I think. I think VERYGAMES, because they've got the money, they are going to go aggressive and try and take the gun. Smith is going to get one. Crystal's going to answer back. And in the end, NBK is going to crab claw them from behind and take down Crystal. So they aren't going to save any weapons from that round. Beyond this slow, methodical pace of play, does it put opponents off? Because the Counter-Strike players, I think, are naturally impatient. They want to be in the action. They want to get kills. Does this maybe force alternate to try and be more aggressive and to push his CT?
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, it's quite simple. If you're holding an angle for 5 seconds compared to like 30 seconds, like after 30 seconds, your aim is going to be way off and your reflexes is going to be worse. It's just, you just can't stay so focused for so long.
Right, well, we've got Scream getting two kills there, and both headshots. Incredible how he managed to control his recoil to do that. But that's going to give VERYGAMES the numerical advantage. MNL with the AWP this time, so again, he's picked it up. They do like to recycle their guns. Very environmentally friendly, this team alternate, but at the moment, not having a huge impact on the scoreboard. And VERYGAMES really... I mean, right now, they're not playing like the flamboyant, all-conquering VERYGAMES we know. To use a football analogy, right now they're playing like Stoke. They're kind of just doing the basics very well, and grinding to victory each round. But while that happened, you can see that MNL does get that AWP kill. And VERYGAMES slowly rotating round to B.
Smith is in the big pit, and his teammate is moving in towards... I think he has to fake now before they go in.
I'll just quickly have a look at that. Yeah, you're absolutely right in the way that they're spread out. So this is interesting. You can see Solid is going to try and put some work with that FAMAS down, but not going to happen. Smith is going to get that kill. That was well observed by Ubion, but MNL is going to get a kill. Felix is going to get the next one. Solon Kenny S, and he's unable to do anything off the screen. Got took down, and Felix is going to get that last kill to give Ultimate a very important round at this stage of the game. It's now 5-2 in favor of VERYGAMES, and you can see that it's Crystal who's top of the frag charts, and Smith top of the frag charts for VERYGAMES, so no change there. So if you were Team Ultimate now, and you were having a hard time getting these CT rounds, you just won one, VERYGAMES playing very slow, grinding you out, what would you be doing?
I would actually try to like take a risk, maybe have 4 guys towards A or 3 guys towards B, because even if you like make the wrong decision, they go the other side, you are able to save your weapons.
Yeah.
Because the things that will happen now, if they lose this round, okay, now they have an eco, so they win this round, is that they will just reset their money all the time, and the score will be like 12-3 before they know it.
Well, it was an eco round, so it went as expected, went the way of alternate, although they did drop 3 bodies there, so VERYGAMES going to have a bit of cash, and you can see that they're able to buy up now. K Kenny S with that up. Crystal again is going to go aggressive on these mid peaks, and it's not something we see a lot of in CSGO. He has managed to tag Kenny S down to 37 HP through the door, so that turned out to be a smart play from him, and I wonder if that will come into play later in the round, that low HP for the VERYGAMES star player. But Ultimate do need to get a foothold in this game. They've won two back-to-back rounds. They need to really take the fight to VERYGAMES without doing anything too stupid, which of course is easier said than done when you've got some of the best brains in the business representing France. So we've got these boosts coming in on short, and they've enjoyed exploring the short area of VERYGAMES. They've had a lot of luck. You can see that Ultimate are playing it like kind of aggressive, and it's cost one of them the life there. Felix getting taken down. MNL's just holding the wraparound at long, you saw there, and Solid just spamming away from the smoke. And VERYGAMES have used these smokes on short incredibly well. They've used them to shut off that kind of catwalk area and to get past the crossover so they can get onto the bomb site. But after doing it, they drop back. Rack in a great position in CT spawn is going to get a kill on MBK, so he was savvy that they were going to drop back into that mid area. And now you can see we've got Scream again, just having a little look. There it is. Ridiculous headshot from him, just nice and crisp. And he's now controlling B, so Rax in a bit of a quandary as to what to do. VERYGAMES obviously are going to go there, and Rax going to get a face full of nade while he was just umming and ahhing about whether to commit to going on the site. Kenny S is going to throw the bomb down and realize there's no one there to throw it to. Solek's going to take down Scream, who's baited into picking up the bomb by that throw, and then he's going to drop down, and he's having a great game. I mean, look at that from Solek. Absolutely huge play just to drop down and to control his aim. And you know what? I don't know. I did mention him at the start. I feel like I should have picked him now because that was just a huge individual bit of play.
Yeah, absolutely phenomenal there. They had a 2v3. VERYGAMES have the bomb site. Everybody who plays CS just knows how ridiculously hard that to be in that position as CT on this map.
Yeah, not only that as well. To be in a position where you're dropping off a box and you have got a split second for your aim to reset itself, to then be able to have the presence of mind to place your crosshair on the heads, just phenomenal. And that great experience from the veteran. What I do find interesting now that is worth commenting on, I've noticed they've gone double AWP now as CT, which you don't see a lot of in CSGO. The double AWP setup's been deemed impractical due to the erratic nature of the gun. And Solek's carrying on where he left off there with two headshots, Doug Smith and Kenny S. This is just an eco round. We shouldn't be too excited about it, but this is going to give them confidence, potentially tie up the game. And you can see Rack's going to get a headshot on the screen as well. Solek's going to get another kill. So three man for him again this round, and MNL's going to get the last one. So about this dual AWP setup as CT, is it a tactic you think can be viable on a CT setup?
It was viable in 1.6. I think you need to have like really good rotation to make it work, since you have to have a Colt defending the AWPs at all time. It's very easy to isolate an AWP on this map, but I don't really know. I think the one AWP is like better in...
Yeah,
I think it's better. Yeah, exactly.
Well, again, if anyone's going to wheel that up, it should be Crystal, because he's managed to tag Kenny S through the door again, down at half HP. So it's just those little frustrating things. And right now, we haven't seen Kenny S have a big impact on this game. And Crystal definitely edging the duel of the two AWPers. And things like that are going to frustrate you, put you off your game. You can see Kenny S staring into mid now. Crystal as well, he's got his crosshair going on. And look at that, he's going to take down Smith, reminiscent of days gone by from Crystal, able to really take that kill with just a pixel peeking through the gap. So great opening kill from him. And of course, with the damage he's done to Kenny S, he's effectively taken out one and a half of VERYGAMES so far. So brilliant individual performance. But you can see VERYGAMES not ruffled. Their jimmies remain unrustled. They're going to be pushing into this long area. And MNL just went for that little peek. Kenny S is able to get the kill. Existence, who has gone up short now, again, using that smoke, they're just going to go for this split. And that's going to force Solek to kind of peek at Carr. Unable to do anything with that. MBK is going to get that kill. And then Scream working the shots from distance. He's probably being shouted at by his teammates. Just plant. Don't peek. It's a 4v3 situation in favor of VERYGAMES, but they have got some low HP people, Existence and Kenny S, both on about half HP. So Ultimate, who we've seen do some good rotates so far, they're doing this little boost here as well in that spot, that affectionately known as gay spot by a lot of people. So Existence is going to read that situation well, get that kill. Rack He's going to get another kill. And then Crystal's going to work, take down Kenny S again at distance. How frustrating for him. And then Rock's going to get another kill. MBK with it all to do. And he's going to hold his nerve and take down two at distance. I thought for a moment Team Alternate were going to do that. But individual brilliance there and good map placement from MBK won the game.
Yeah, exactly. And I actually think VERYGAMES thought for a second that Alternate was going to save. So they started playing a bit careless. They lost three fast people. So
bodies dropping
big
left,
risk
right,
there. So. You always have to send out only one guy to hunt them.
So quick look at the frag charts. You can see Solek still rocking it for Alternate on 9 for 8. And Smith's still at the top as well, so not a lot of change there. They've been pretty much the two guys worth talking about, although I think Crystal's been doing some impeccable work with Yorp. Got a rifle this round. I'm going to say it's 6 for 5 to VERYGAMES. Alternate have had some close rounds. I mean, this has been a game, again, just like what we saw in the first one, on a knife edge. It really can go either way. And while you would fancy VERYGAMES to do it, I've got to be honest, I think recent defeats are playing on their mind because they're playing too passive. For me, I think they need to really get this game by the scruff of the neck and play some fast strats, put Alternate off balance.
Yeah, try pushing towards B. I mean, they have an AWP inside B. They just try to go for a
they're learning these A splits.
B split towards an AWP is like the best thing to do.
Well, again, your crystal ball.
Yeah. They're going for a B split here, and Crystal is all alone. Yeah. Was in an AWP? No, he has an M4.
Yeah, he has got an M4, so he should be okay. Solek with a great long range. Oh. Joe Crystal, there you go. That's what happens. An auto director said, you know what, it's not even worth watching. And Crystal just got 2 kills, so he was all alone. Comes up trumps, but Existence is going to get that kill. Crystal up with a 3-man now. Great nade straight on the Smith's head. Catch that. And Existence is the last man standing. Can he clutch? He's had his detractors this season. No, he can't. Crystal, who was all alone, the man that you felt was isolated and going to get exploited for that, comes up huge to tie this game up for Alternate.
Yeah, that was Crystal's round, no doubt about it. I mean, it's so hard as CT if you get split towards B. It's like you have to make a decision. Do I decide to kill the Gauss coming from middle, or do I decide to push Dark Hallways? And he decided to push Dark Hallways, and he killed both of them and got the bomb down, I think.
And it looks like we've got an eco coming in, so Alternate are in a position here to take the lead. And what a turnaround that'd be, especially on CT. So I got to ask you, what do you think's changed? Why are things seeming to go the way of Alternate when VERYGAMES had such a good start to the game?
I don't know. Maybe their new lineup. Is it the first event with Scream? I think it is. Like LAN event.
No, I think they went to... Did they go to Epsilon? I think. Oh, it went all squeaky there. That's how did they go to Epsilon? I think they did. Yeah, they went to Epsilon. So they have had a LAN with Scream, yeah.
Yeah, anyways.
Just that confirmation.
They seem about a bit stressed out. They actually had a timeout eco now. A timeout eco is, of course, when you stand in spawn just talking about what to do next.
Mm. Yeah, of course, yeah. So obviously they're looking to switch things up here, and this eco round's not going to change the momentum of the way it's going. And it's all German at the moment. MNL starting to find his aim as well. Again, I know that was an eco, but that's perhaps a turning point in the game because Alternate have got the lead. They're thinking, you know what, VERYGAMES, they were meant to be a tough game for us.
Worth noting is that VERYGAMES lost to Anexis. Alternate lost to Anexis in last game, so...
Yeah. Well, the thing was, again, I thought, as I said at the start of the cast, they had a good game last game. I thought they'd actually won. So Anexis came back, did they? Because they were
winning
for one. Oh, wow. Okay, cool. So I don't even know the results from my own bloody event. I'm a good caster. Hire me again, please. Alternate probably is very motivated going into this game.
Yeah, exactly. And if Alternate wins this, VERYGAMES might be out of the group stage.
Well, I mean, possible.
Yeah, okay. Yeah, of course, it's 3.
Yeah, it is the top.
Yeah,
but I like the way you're hyping the drama. It's good. Let's build that narrative. But while that's being talked about, you can see as well that MBK picking up some kills, and VERYGAMES is going to tie this up. I've got no doubt about that. MBK and Kenny S doing work for VERYGAMES. See MBK, he's had a classic Nathan Nizzle, as he likes to call himself. He had a great round there and picked up some kills to tie it up at 7-7. So it's the deciding round in the half, and naturally we're going to see Alternate buy whatever they can. So we've got, what's that, a Mag 7 coming in. We got a FAMAS. And just a pistol for Solek. So very interesting to see how this will work out.
I mean, this round is like, even if VERYGAMES wins this round, I think that they will be disappointed with this half and ultimately.
Oh, definitely. Yeah, there's no doubt about that. Scream gets one headshot and then puts up another kill. Solek's going to get a nade down on Scream to remove him from the equation. You can see the back of him. If you're a German fan, you can see as well that Smith have managed to get a kill back for VERYGAMES, and it's looking very good at the moment for VERYGAMES. M&L in a great position though. He's going to make that count. Ooh, I thought he was going to miss that. That would have been awkward. But he does get Smith in the end, so it's now a 2v3 situation in favor of the French. So the French team are going to push up short. You can see from the x-ray where everyone is. And VERYGAMES won't know that, but they're just spamming the areas anyway. A bomb site's clear, it's free for the plant. And M&L's coming around on short. Got to get this kill, you think, doesn't. MBK again going into that crouch and just gets that headshot. He's tapping away again. Might pick up another kill here, but Felix with it all to do. And not really happening. And the VERYGAMES are all taking it in turns, I think, to peek him. They're not really facing him all at once. It was like they wanted MBK to get the frag, and in the end, there you go. It's 8-7 at half time. And VERYGAMES, they made a bit of a meal of that, I think. It was a bit laborious. We got, what's this? No, Nathan, we got a WTF coming in. Not even sure what's going on, but we'll try and get some light on that. But let's just talk about the half while the players are readying up. So there you have it. It was, I wouldn't say it was a hugely entertaining game. It was a bit strange because VERYGAMES seemed to be in control at one point, and then they were playing it slow. They were dictating the pace. The Germans came right back into it. And Team Alternate, I would say, if we were going on what happened at the end of that half, I think they looked a little bit stronger.
Yeah, absolutely agree. I mean, VERYGAMES played the right strategies, but Alternate just managed to get like weird double kills and stuff like that, like Crystal and B. Yeah, let's see the second pistol round here.
Yeah, I was going to say, we'll come back to that in details. And we've got some people skating in. So VERYGAMES got their skates on. Literally, they're going into B, and you can see that Crystal's been taken down, which is good news for VERYGAMES. Smith is going to get another kill. And Felix trying to answer back. He is going to get that kill onto Smith. That is going to enable Alternate to get up, and it's an 8 split. So MBK's getting absolutely jackhammered from all over the place. You see, M&L's got the kill with Scream on the rotate. He's just gone super aggressive and picked up two kills, two little headshots. So it's a 1v3 for Rack, and there is just one bullet. He didn't even spam his pistol. He knew he was making that headshot.
Great round there for Scream. Like, that's what VERYGAMES need right now, like individual performances.
Well, you've been critical of him in the past, but there was an example of him being aggressive and it actually working out for the team because he rotated very quickly and got himself into that position to make those three kills. So
yeah, but I think it's a difference between being aggressive as CT or T. And it seems like the game has frozen.
Yeah, have we got a pause coming in maybe? I'm not too sure. Again, it's very hard to know what's going on at the event. I'll see if we can get some in-ear from the admins. I'll just talk to the producer. Do we have any idea what's happening over with the game? Is it a pause? Is the game paused? Yeah? So it looks like there's been a pause for some sort. We have got a relay going direct to the tournament admins. So, I mean, I guess we can fade out and maybe look at our ugly mugs again. It's good because it gives us time to talk. And we didn't have a lot of time to really sell this game and build it up. So in the context of the group, you were saying that Alternate had lost their first game to an Nexus. So this becomes a vitally important game. VERYGAMES, I'm guessing that how it went for them in their first game. I mean,
they won pretty easily versus Logix.
Yeah, I thought they would have beat Logix quite comfortably. So in terms of this, I mean, this is very important for the Germans to get a result here. Do you see indications that it could happen, or do you think VERYGAMES are looking like they're just going to somehow grind their way to victory?
Yeah, I think they're going to grind their way to victory. As you said earlier, they're just playing standard, and just if they just play standard good enough, it will be enough for them to win. And I mean, it was a bit shaky the first half, but I feel it's kind of